everyone. I hope everyone is doing well. Everyone is safe and healthy, of course. The days of Noah is taking place. And Christ even said in the last days would be like the day of Noah. Now firmly believe that. We are witnessing it now. Not just throughout Europe, but India and Africa. I want to take you here. This is very important. This has occurred over the last couple of days, and I want to show you that are we being protected? Look at this. This is the X-ray flux data. And I'm going to take you to show you what happened. Now this is for the last 3 days. Now look at this. This is occurring on the back side of the sun. You haven't seen anything yet. Just wait a second. Now watch. That right there would have been the kill shot for this planet. If that happened, ladies and gentlemen, there would be no electricity for about 5 years. But look at it. Something is not right. The planetary system is approaching, and we know this. And the earthquakes is not even here yet. They are happening, but I believe we are going to witness events that have never been seen before. We are going to witness magnitude 7s throughout the world. And then the 8s and then the 9s are coming. I'm going to take you to the jet stream before we get started with this video. Look how inadequate it is. This is not normal. And this deals with the weakening of the magnetosphere, the center of the Earth's core. And it's affecting everything. The magnetosphere, the magnetic sphere, both is being affected. Look at this jet stream coming down through Germany. This is today. And it's going to go down into Greece and other parts of the Mediterranean. But look at this. It's not over. We are going to look at the weather in this area. But other parts of the world about to get affected with this flooding. Now, some people believe it's, you know, geoengineering. Yes, it's highly possible. But I believe a lot of it deals with the weakening of the magnetosphere. And because of that, our jet streams is totally out of whack. And this is causing massive amount of flooding. Now, if you look at this area here, this is in the northern region where the magnetic north is moving. But this is not right to have them skip around and not a very consistent flow in the northern hemisphere. This is the Antarctic. Now, I did not change this program, but this is in the Antarctic, and look what's fixing to take place and what's taking place in Australia. And I'm going to back it down so you can see, but they're going to get a tremendous amount of rain that's coming. So I believe a lot of this weather phenomenon that is happening deals with the weakening of the magnetosphere, and that's about 10 subjects into one. And I'm going to take you to the area of Germany, and we are going to look at the weather for a brief moment. But there it is at the top. I'm going to zoom in so you can see Germany. This is the area. Now look at the wind coming down from the north. This wind will intensify once it hits landmass as well as the mountains in Germany. But Hamburg is not seen the end of it. It has not. And it's going to be more flooding in those regions, as well as what's taking place in Belgium. Now, I did not put the videos what's taking place in Belgium. I simply wanted to keep this down to about 30-35 minutes so I can deal with the earthquakes that will go into production right after this video. But Switzerland, now they are getting a huge amount of rain 24 hours ago. But this is not normal. Not for that area of Europe. And it's not normal for Germany to get this type of flooding. It is simply not. And it's going to continue. And you can see in the lower screen about the area of huge amount of lightning that's taking place as well. But I'm going to take you here. I received a picture late last night, and I couldn't confirm it, but I did this morning. I've spent hours. The dam has ruptured. Listen to me. People were sending me messages that the dam is still there. It is not there. Here's the picture to prove it. Now, there's no videos out. There may be some this evening, but as of now, there's no videos dealing with the dam that has ruptured. And as you can see, the landmass and how it goes down in an angle, that was a dam. And it reached a breaking point, and basically it collapsed. Now, I cannot fully confirm this, but if you look at the picture, this is the only picture that's out right now stating that the dam did rupture. Also, I'm going to take you to a tweak, and this woman put this information up. Here in Germany, dozens have died. No, hundreds have died, and thousands are missing now, and they lost their home. It's a disaster. This is the climate crisis unrevealing to the world. Some of the richest parts of the world. And Germany, as you know, is not used to this. There is no safe places anymore. And that's what she's stating here. Now, this tweet came out today, this morning. So we are going to watch the videos about 10 to 15 minutes, and then I'm going to comment at the end.
Here in Hagen, the rains overnight that were forecast didn't turn out to be that heavy, and we haven't seen any further rain falling on these already swollen rivers and lakes and already sodden ground so far on Friday. On Thursday, though, where I'm speaking to you from, saw a 120-year high watermark reached in just a few hours after the rainfall came down and swept away large amounts of everything that was by the sides of the rivers. I'm speaking to you now just in front of a bridge that was under construction at the time. Locals are telling me that, construction equipment that was on that bridge was swept away as if it was nothing. The work of trying to sure that construction up and making sure that if there is any further swells in the river here that no more damage can be done. That's the physical cost, the material cost, but unfortunately and tragically the human cost of this natural disaster is still well beyond being counted. What we understand is a number of people are still counted as missing. In fact, in one area of the state of Rhineland-Palatinate, the local authorities tweeting out that 1,300 people were counted as missing as far as they're concerned. What that may well be down to, and what we're obviously hoping that's down to, is the fact that the telecommunications networks in a lot of areas aren't functioning properly. People aren't able to get in touch with one another. However, tragically, in that particular town of Arweiler, we did get news on Thursday evening that 9 bodies had been found in a home for disabled people. Rescuers had gone to the home to try and rescue those people that were in that facility. However, it's the speed and the ferocity at which waters rose that has really caused so many problems and caught so many people off guard. Unfortunately, the number of dead continues to rise in both the Rhineland-Palatinate and here in the state of North Rhine-Westphalia, where I'm speaking to you from. That idea of the waters coming in so quickly was also repeated in the town of Schuld, which is just down the river from the town of Arweiler. People there told us what it was like when that water started to rise.
I haven't experienced that before, what came here. It happened so fast. We couldn't look as fast as the water came.
It was really bad. At first we laughed that it wouldn't be so bad, but then it got really bad. There was more and more and more water. Then we were told that we had to leave the house.
I've seen footage from the air of the scale of the destruction. You're looking at rivers that have burst their banks and flooded kilometers away from their usual boundaries, people's homes well and truly flooded away. In the town of Hagen, where I'm talking to you from, the authorities were saying last night, make sure you can, if you can, to sleep on the higher floors of the houses, to remain there. Also not to drink the drinking water because, the flood water from the river has overfilled into the town's water supply. Near to Cologne, not too far away in the same state, a number of houses were washed away overnight. Several others also in a state of being partially washed away. Others, the authorities doing their best along with locals to try and make sure that they can put anything they can in place to make sure that they aren't the next ones to be washed away. When it comes to rescuing people in the Cologne region, rescuers having to use boats as the only way to get down streets to do that. Also in one area, a gas leak that can't be turned off is also making things incredibly more dangerous, not just for those in need of rescuing, but also for the rescuers who are having to go in to do that much needed and incredibly dangerous job. The German army has also been drafted in, has been on the scene for well over 24 hours now, is in trying to help coordinate those rescue efforts. But the damage is, financially wise, that's obviously not the main concern at the moment, but down the line that will be running into the hundreds and hundreds of millions of euro, if not more than that. I think almost certainly it will be more than that, but it's the human cost at the moment that we're still struggling to try and get a real fix on just how high that may be. It is already incredibly high, with a large number of people losing their lives both in Western Germany, also in Belgium, other areas affected by these floods as well, in the Netherlands, in France and in Luxembourg as well. This is really a tragedy that's crossed all of those borders. We'll be keeping an eye on all of the updates that come out of this particular part of Western Germany throughout the day. Any new information, I'll bring it to you.
Yeah.
Scheiße!
Mach das Auto auf! Mach das Auto auf!
Oh nein!
Vater, ey. Das ist ganz sehr, Mann. Das
Leute, das hier ist nicht mehr normal. Guckt euch das mal an. Oh wei, hier kommt ein Auto, oh wei.
Echt, oh, dit is echt. Ja, je kunt er niks tegen doen. Je kunt er niks tegen doen. Het is echt. Oei, 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 oei. Oh, dit is echt.
Put my lean out here.
Oh wei, hier kommt ein Auto. Oh wei.
Ich würde sagen, dem witterungsbedingten Umstand nicht allzu wohl. Insbesondere, wenn man, Sie können es hier sehen, ist überall in den Häusern Schlamm von die Brücke hin abgestürzt, Wasser rüber, weiter runter sind sogar Häuser weggeschwommen. Also es ist Notstand wie im Zweiten Weltkrieg.
When I see people that have lost their homes and their livelihood and everything they worked for their entire life, whether it's the Netherlands, Belgium, France, the protesting in France is taking place, Cuba as well. But what is going on throughout the world, ladies and gentlemen, this civilization has been pushed to the point that we are disconnected from Mother Earth and Father Sky and the Great Spirit of the Heavenly Father. We are. Most of us, not all of us, and I'm so grateful for each and every one of you. I am so proud of all of you, because we are on the same page. We are in the same chapter. We are in the same book. The days of Noah? Yes, it's very possible, isn't it? But when I see people losing their homes and their loved ones, and now they're saying thousands are missing, it really affects me. I was planning on doing the earthquakes today, and I'm going to work on it this evening, and I'm going to get it out first thing in the morning. But something is happening. Something is not right. And I believe we are connected to this planet. Global consciousness is at an all-time low. With this virus and family members getting the jab and people are trying to, you know, wake up their significant other, and people are like, if you don't wake up, I'm leaving you. You know, talk to them, ladies and gentlemen. Don't leave your loved ones. This is happening all throughout the world, and the darkness is upon us now. It's spreading. I have never seen it like this. Never in my entire life. And neither have you. I'm going to put together a wonderful spiritual message this Sunday. And I hope all of you that are watching this video will be there. And it's going to be very powerful. And it's going to be about you. And it's going to be about me. And your significant others. Your family members. We have to get it together, ladies and gentlemen. Because we're going to fail. This civilization is failing. But I love you all. Please be strong and continue in prayer. Much love, everyone. Be safe. And God bless always.